Hello everyone. Welcome back to our channel. It's not a very we are going through a very hard time, and I don't know how you are passing your days in isolation, and how much worry is Rona putting on you. Yes, I said Rona instead of Corona. This shortened form has already emerged. And not only this, actually, some other mashup words regarding this life-threatening and virus and our current lifestyle are on the horizon. That means there are more words, okay, are on the way. There are more words on the way regarding this virus. Let's meet those newly baked yet trendy words that coronavirus or COVID-19 teaches us. And this collection has been brought to you by dictionary.com. So let's begin. It's a kind of new method of making any kind of lesson. So I haven't done anything for my channel. So this is the very first time I'm doing. Okay. Let's see. So words that coronavirus taught us. Okay. So this is what or how the virus looks like. It's very creepy, right? First comes Rona. So what is Rona? Rona is an informal shortening of coronavirus. Coronavirus is popularly shortened to Corona. So the name was coronavirus and it was shortened to Corona. And then again, it was shortened to Rona. I'm not sure if this one will be shortened as well, like Ro or just Na. I'm not sure. An example. Yeah, I don't know about you, but homeschooling my kids during the Rona ends up in a lot of frozen too. So many parents are facing that kind of thing. Next comes doom scrolling. So doom and scrolling, they are making this term. So life under Rona, the Rona has meant that it's even harder to peel our eyes away from our phones and computers, constantly refreshing our feeds for the latest news about the pandemic. So we don't want to know any news regarding coronavirus, but we have to do, because who knows who is going to be sick next day or next hour. Okay, so an example. I was up 2 a.m. last night doom scrolling. I was just scrolling and scrolling and scrolling about coronavirus news in my state. Okay, so this is how we scroll usually. It's just a plain sketch. Next comes COVIDiot. So a blend of COVID-19 and idiot. COVIDiot is a slang insult for someone who disregards health and safety guidelines about the novel coronavirus. So some signs of COVIDiot are not washing your hands. If you don't wash your hands regularly, if you hang out in group of people, if you stand within 6 feet of a stranger at the grocery, or if you hoard items like toilet paper and hand sanitizer all to yourself, congratulations, you are a pure COVIDiot. Okay, an example. Don't be a COVIDiot by visiting the beach today. It's super crowded. So, you know, it's a picture. Okay, so people sometimes, some people like that kind of closeness or togetherness, but you know, this is not the best time to practice that kind of thing. So we must avoid doing anything like that. So don't be COVIDiot. Okay. So next comes moronavirus. So moronavirus is a really nice one. This word centers on the word moron. So moron means just like a COVIDiot, okay? So COVIDiot and moron, they're typically same. So moronavirus, if any people act stupid or like idiot in this period, that person can be called as moronavirus. An example, my roommate is being such a moronavirus. He went down to the beach with a huge group of friends. So definitely moronavirus. And if you are someone like that, congratulations, you are moron of the week. Okay, next comes quarantini. So what quarantini means? So quarantini is a slang term for a cocktail people drink at home while under quarantine during and because of the coronavirus. So if you drink the cocktail that is called martini, and if you do it during quarantine, then it can be called quarantini. That means you are in quarantine and you are drinking martini. So quarantini, nice one. So the term is a blend of quarantine and martini, a cocktail made with gin or vodka and dry vermouth, usually served with a green olive or a twist of lemon peel. So this is how martini typically looks like. Okay. Let's move on. It's an example. Let's move on. Coronarita. Okay. So it's also all about a drink, and it's not, and the name of the drink is margarita. So if you drink margarita during this period, this coronavirus, you could say coronarita. That means I am in quarantine, and at the same time I like to or love to, or I'm drinking margarita. Okay, so this is how margarita is made. It's a cocktail made of tequila, I'm not sure if the correct pronunciation is like that, lime or lemon juice, and orange flavored liqueur, usually served in a salt rimmed glass. Okay. Next comes, oh, this is coronarita looks like. Okay, I mean margarita looks like. Virtual happy hour. So first you have to know what happy hour means. Happy hour is a cocktail hour or longer period at a bar during which drinks are served at reduced prices with, prices or with free snacks. So it could be maybe your weekend, right? People love to get together and they spend a longer period. They spend at bar, you know, longer than usual. And as many people are drinking at a time, at the same time, so the bartenders, okay, they reduce the price, okay, and also not only that, they sometimes offer free snacks. So that is called happy hour. But now we are not going to, I mean, we cannot do it, I mean people cannot do it, so they are doing it online. Okay, so they are, you know, get themselves connected with others through different kind of apps, and that is called virtual happy hour. And they use typically Zoom, FaceTime, or Google Hangouts. Okay, and right now I'm using Zoom. So Zoom is an incredible software. Okay, so FaceTime, Hangout, Zoom, and the next one is really nice one: quarantines or Corona babies. When two people get really cozy while quarantine and chilling, they may, you know, da da da. So when two people, for example, husband and wife. So when they are, I mean, while quarantine, they have better opportunity to come closer. They have more time to make love and so on. And, you know, there is a great chance for the woman or the lady to be conceived with baby or babies. So when these babies will be born, they will be called quarantines. Corona baby or babies if there is twin or a triplet or more. Okay, so corona babies. Okay. And when these babies will be a teenager, they will be called quarantine. So when these babies get older, they will become the quarantines. That means quarantine. It's a really nice one. Maybe we have to wait another 13 years to see them in full action, right? And next comes COVID divorce. So the experience for other couples under COVID-19 quarantine may not be so snuggly. Being in extended isolation with loved ones can strain our relationship. That means, being together for a long time is not good for always. I mean, it's not good for everybody. Sorry. Okay. So maybe they may get bored because they are doing the same thing over and over and over again without taking any break. So some people or few people may see the decline in their relationship, and, you know, if it is the worst case, they may ask for divorce. Okay, so if the virus is involved and if any divorce takes place, you could say COVID divorce. Okay, so COVID-19 was the reason. Okay, you should kill him, We should kill it, right? So COVIDiverse, okay. And the last one is coronacation. So what is coronacation? First, you have to know what is staycation. So staycation is a kind of vacation that you have, but at the same time you are staying at your home. So if you stay at your home and you are on a vacation, that is called a staycation, right? So coronacation is same as staycation. If you stay at your home or if you are confined to a place, and if you are on vacation. Right now, millions of people are on vacation and they're called kind of coronacation, okay? Because they cannot move and they cannot enjoy, okay? So they cannot enjoy the vacation, okay? So they cannot, you know, utilize the time, okay? So you could say coronacation, okay? There could be an example. Yes, my teen thinks he's getting a coronacation since his school has moved online. Okay, so he's talking about his teen, and he is attending his classes online. At the same time, he is staying at his home. So it's really a perfect example of coronacation. Coronavirus is the reason. Okay. And oh, wait until he sees how I am going to keep him busy with dictionary.com's learning at home resources. Okay. Yes, we should give a special thanks to dictionary.com for making this incredible and wonderful list. Okay. And that's all about today's lesson. So I hope you understood and enjoyed. Well, if you did, just hit the thumbs up below and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, to your YouTube channel, Engvlog. One more thing. That is, whatever you do, whenever you go, wherever you go, try to be careful as much as possible. It's not for you only. It's for the people around you. So take care of yourself and take care of them as well. Thank you. Bye-bye.